So this Ranga's marriage is a comment upon Western culture and its impact upon Indian way of thinking plus action. In the story, Ranga, who is the protagonist? He is the one who has gone to get education from a city. He belongs to a village, but he is one of the fortunate persons who got a chance to go to city and get education. So he learned English. So this is what is commonly, it's a preconceived idea that anyone who knows English or speaks English is best friend. People think so. So when after completing education from the city, after having learned English, you can say, when Ranga comes back to village, then the whole village were apprehensive about how Ranga might be looking now. They thought like after having learned English and getting more education, he might have changed. So they think like Ranga might have changed. What is change? What is change? What change we expect when we say like somebody might have changed? Behavior, lifestyle, okay? Behavior, lifestyle, what else? What do we say like, how can we say like somebody has changed? Thoughts. Thoughts. Is the blackboard visible? Yes. So when we find that somebody's behavior has changed, thoughts have changed, or his lifestyle has changed, we say somebody has changed. This is how we usually, think like it's our preconceived idea. So when this Ranga comes from city, then the villagers think like he might have changed. And they throng his house, they come to his house. And they find like the whole village is there to see Ranga. And Ranga comes out his house to cheer the villagers. And the people, one of them was a old woman. She literally touched this Ranga and saw that he was the same. So the point is, does somebody change physically? One doesn't change physically. But these villagers, innocent villagers, they even thought like he might have changed physically. So one of the old women, she even tried to touch him and saw like he was the same Ranga. But the biggest thing that made her say that he had not changed was that Ranga knew the old values. When he saw some old acquaintance, some person who was there, some old person, some elderly person, Ranga touched his feet. And moreover, he was still wearing that sacred thread, which many Indians, usually wear. That is a part of our culture. Okay, the way Sikhs wear turban, in the similar way, some Hindus wear sacred thread. So it's a part of culture. So when they saw like Ranga was still wearing that sacred thread, he was still touching the feet of the elders, then they commented that Ranga had not changed. But is it enough to say that whether somebody has changed or not? Is it enough? Yes. If you are learning, if you're able to learn some foreign language, that doesn't mean that you forget your own culture. That doesn't mean that you forget your own values. One might speak in any language, but one's culture remains, it remains in his heart. That is one aspect. Then the biggest thing about the effect of other culture is when that culture changes your mindset, when it affects your thoughts. We people are pure, our thoughts are affected by our culture. What our culture tells us, we do that, isn't it? What is culture? What is true to our soil? That is culture. Okay, when we are true to our culture, that is okay. But when westernization affects us, then we first start forgetting our culture, first of all. And you people find out through the story, like, has Ranga changed that way? Has westernization changed his thoughts or way of thinking? Let's find out. I'm leaving this question upon you. Has westernization changed Ranga's thoughts? Has he started thinking differently? Find it out yourself. It's a very important question. Okay, because this was the theme of the chapter. Okay, but in the very beginning, I would like to assert, because this is what you people always will, misinterpret. No language ever changes your mindset. If you speak English, you will not forget the roots of your culture. Okay? You will know that. But yes, you might pretend as if you are forgetting it, but it will be there forever. Okay? So Ranga's marriage. Yes, so let's start the reading now. Ranga, the accountant's son, is one of the rare breed among the village folk who has been to the city to pursue his studies. So what do you mean by this? Like, he's one of the rare breed. Like, he's like, not everybody from the village goes to get higher education from city. He's one of the people, he's one of those who went to city. So only a few, just one out of 100. So one of the rare breed means very few people go to city to pursue his studies. When he returns to his village from the city of Bangalore, the crowds mill around his house to see whether he has changed or not. So when he comes back from the city of Bangalore, when he comes back to his village, then all villagers come to his house to see whether he has changed. His ideas about marriage are now quite different. Or are they? So the biggest change which has come over this boy, which seems to be there, that it is the change in his ideas of marriage. So people will say that Ranga has changed, Ranga has not changed. But then the narrator of the story, he will see that Ranga is a very eligible bachelor and should be married now. In Indian setup, what usually happens when the boy has got finished studies and has started earning a little bit, then they think like, now the boy is very eligible to get married off. But if the boy has not started earning, the boy has not, got to be independent, in Indian setup, people say ki abhi he should not. Okay, eligible bachelor means the one who is well educated and who has settled. That is what in Indian system we say. So that narrator says ki now this Ranga, is a very, very eligible bachelor and he should get married. And in Indian setup, with whom do the elderly want their children to marry? They want that their children should go for an arranged marriage. What happens in an arranged marriage? The elders seek an alliance for the children as per the child. They go for a proper match on their own. Right? And that system of arranged marriage is guaranteed by the elderly, experience. Their elders, they have their own experience. They know what is suitable for one or the other party. Then only they fix the marriage. Okay? But what happens with the modern westernized effect? The children go for they go for their own matchmaking. They think like their parents cannot, their elders cannot make out like what we need. So what is wrong about that concept? They are the one, the youngsters, you know, they lack experience. They have not seen the life. And moreover, they only see the other person's good qualities, only the positive things. Whereas they remain ignorant about their family background, because in the end, it is match of not only a boy and girl, it's a match of two families, two cultures, two backgrounds. Because after marriage, it's not that the boy and girl only have to stay together. The boy and girls have to stay, have to make many arrangements or adjustments with the families also. So most of the disputes in the families are because of the families. And the boy and the girl, when they are not able to adjust with their each other's families, then they go for divorce. But when the elderly people intervene and when they go for an arranged marriage, then they even see whether the families are also in sync with each other. They see whether families are of the same nature, of the same kinds of background. But these things are totally ignored by the youngsters. So you can well imagine which case is better. Elderly one, the one which is put forward by the elderly, or the one which is thought about by the youngsters. In case of youngsters, experience lacks. But in case of elderly people, sometimes the exact sync lacks. But there are more positive points, right? So now let's see. Ranga has not changed, but yes, he has changed as far as his ideology about marriage is concerned. Because after education, Ranga thinks that now he should not go for an arranged marriage. He wants to marry a girl whom he knows. It's not that he has found any girl. It's not that. But he thinks that he will marry when he will find a suitable girl. But the narrator wants him to marry a girl which he thinks will be very suitable for her. Now we will see whether narrator, that is the elderly person, wins or Ranga wins. Right? But if the narrator wins, that would be for the good of narrator also. Isn't it? Getting or not? So when you see this title, some of you may ask, Ranga's marriage, why not Ranganatha Viva or Ranganatha Vijaya? So when you will read this title, you might be wondering like, why such a simple title? Why not Ranganatha's Viva, something like this? Means why not a fancy title? Well, yes, I know I could have used some other mouth filling one like Jagannatha Vijay or Girija Kalyan, but then this is not about Jagannatha's victory or Girija's wedding. It's about our own Ranga's marriage, and hence no fancy title. So because it's actually the wedding of our own Ranga, a common boy. So that's why he says, I've not gone in for any fancy or high profiled title. Koshali is our village. So which place is here to which this Ranga belongs? Koshali. You may pronounce it as Hozali or whatever. You must have heard of it. No? What a pity. But it's not your fault. There is no mention of it in any geography book. Those sahibs in England, writing in English, probably do not know that such a place exists. And so make no mention of it. So if you don't know where Koshali is, then it's not your fault, because it's the fault of those cartographers, those who made maps and those who do work on geography. Those English people might not be even knowing that this place actually exists. So those sahibs in England writing in English probably do not know that such a place exists. And so make no mention of it. Our own people too forget about it. You know how it is. They are like a flock of sheep. One sheep walks into a pit, the rest blindly follow it. when both the sahibs in England and our own geographers have not referred to it, you cannot expect the poor cartographer to remember to put it in the, on the map. Who is the cartographer? The one who studies maps, okay? The one who goes in for the making of the maps and all. And so there is not even the shadow of our village on any map. So why is there no Hoshiali village on the map? Because the English forgot to put the village on the map, and there after independence, even no one from Indian, Indian system got to have this in the, on the map. So it's not there. Sorry, I started somewhere and then went off in another direction. So from where did he start actually? He started with Ranga, but he went to Hoshiali. Then he started talking about cartographers and all. So he says, sorry for it. If the state of Mysore is to Bharat Varsha, what the sweet kari gavadu is to the festive meal, then Hoshiali is to Mysore state, what the filling is to kariga dabbu. So he says, like, if you talk about Hoshiali is as important to Mysore. So you might have got a reference like Hoshiali is in Mysore. If you talk about Punjab, then you cannot talk about Punjab without Amritsar. So in the same way, if you talk about Mysore, he says you cannot talk about Mysore without Hoshiali. What I have said is absolutely true. Believe me, I will not object to your questioning it, but I will stick to my opinion. I'm not the one who speaks glowingly of Hoshiali. We have a doctor in our place. His name is Gunda Bhatta. He agrees with me. He has been to quite a few places. No, not England. If anyone asks him whether he has been there, he says, no, Anya, I have left that to you. Running around like a flea-pestered dog is not for me. I have seen a few places in my lifetime, though, as a matter of fact, he has seen many. So what he's only saying in this whole paragraph, that this Hoshiali place is worth visiting. It's one of the most beautiful places. And he says that even the doctor of our village agrees with me. Why he refers the doctor? Because the doctor is the one who has visited many places. So even he says that this is a very beautiful place. That's why he says that this is one of the most beautiful places to visit. We have some mango trees in our village. Come visit us and I'll give you a raw mango from one of them. Do not eat it. Just take a bite. The sourness is sure to go straight to your Brahmandra. That is, he says, like, if you come to our place, then you'll come to know that our place is very, very conspicuous or noticeable because of our mango, the kind of variety of mango. And when you come and if I give you a raw mango, then don't just have it full. Just have a bite. Then just its one bite will make you realize that it's very sour. I once took one such fruit home and chutney was made out of it. All of us ate it. The cough we suffered from after that. It was when I went for the cough medicine that the doctor told me about the special quality of the fruit. Got it? So what is special about the mango? That the mangoes of this place are very sour because of a special quality. Just as the mango is special, so is everything else around our village. We have a creeper growing in the ever so fine water of the village pond. The flowers are a feast to behold. What does it mean? Its flowers are a feast to behold. Its flowers are worth watching. Very beautiful. You need to look at them. So they are a feast to behold means that they are feast to look at. They are feast for your eyes. Get two leaves from the creeper when you go to the pond for your bath, and you will not have to worry about not having leaves on which to serve the afternoon meal. So when you go to take bath in the river, then you also carry with you the leaves. Then you will not have to worry about the afternoon meal because those leaves will serve as a plate. You will say that I'm rambling. It's always like that. when the subject of our village comes up. But enough, if any one of you would like to visit us, drop me a line. I'll let you know where Hoshali is and what things are like there. The best way of getting to know a place is to visit it. Don't you agree? So finally, he says, I'm just telling you to just write me a letter and I'll tell you in details like where this place is. So what I'm going to tell you is something that happened 10 years ago. We did not have many people who knew English then. Our village accountant was the first one who had enough courage to send his son to Bangalore to study. So it happened about 10 years ago when not many people knew English. Okay. Then the village accountant sent his son to Bangalore to study. It is different now. There are many who know English. During the holidays, you come across them on every street talking in English. Those days, we did not speak in English, nor did we bring in English words like talking in Kannada. So this story about Rangao marriage is something which happened how many years ago? 10 years ago. So then what was the very important thing to know? Then not many people used to speak English. It was at that time that the village accountant sent his son to Bangalore to study. But now he says that things are different. What is different now? Now people know English. Now there are people whom he says we see talking in English on streets. And now we even see people mixing local language with English. Here people do what people do? They mix Punjabi with English. They mix Hindi with English. English, right? And he says this was the same thing even in that time. So what has happened is a disgraceful, believe me. What is a disgraceful, Japan Jyoti? What is a disgraceful? What is a disgraceful? Dhruv Agarwal will tell us. Unmute yourself, Dhruv. Dhruv Agarwal, unmute yourself. Okay, Harshvardhan, unmute yourself. Amritpal, unmute yourself. Amritpal. Chirag Ahuja, unmute yourself. Gursirat Singh, unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, who is the speaker? Yes, who is the speaker? Gursirat, you or Harshvardhan?
Ma'am, Gursirat.
Yes, Gursirat. So, Gursirat, what is disgraceful?
Ma'am, can I think?
Yes, speaker. What is disgraceful? What has happened is disgraceful, believe me. So, what is disgraceful here? Yes, come on.
Ma'am, which is not believable. Which is difficult to believe on.
No, beta, no. What is disgraceful, he says. Yes, anyone who knows, raise hand from online classes. Yes, children, I'm going to write this notice in the classroom today, in the group. It will be compulsory for the children to turn on video when you are attending class. When your video is turned off, you will be marked absent. Turning off video is not allowed in the classes. You have the facility to study from home. But yes, when you are studying with video off and not even around it, that is not done. So keep your videos on when you are in the class from tomorrow. Today, take your time, get ready, because maybe you are not well dressed up, or maybe you are not even there. But tomorrow you should know this. So anyways, we were talking about what has happened is a disgraceful. What's the answer? Raise hand. Yes, mixing English with other local language is disgraceful. Okay, neither people know their own local language nor they know the foreign language. Okay, the other day I was in Rama Rao's house when they bought a bundle of firewood. Right, Rama Rao's son came out to pay for it. He asked the woman, "How much should I give you?" 4 pies, she said. The boy told her he did not have any change and asked her to come the next morning. The poor woman did not understand the English word change and went away muttering to herself. I too did not know. Later, when I went to Ranga's house and asked him, I understood what it meant. So see what happened? It was a Rama Rao's family son. It was at the house of Rama Rao. A woman came to give them firewood. Okay, but when she was given money, which she had to return, she was told that he did not have change. She did not understand the meaning of change. And later on, even narrator also did not know this. So there was a lot of confusion. So finally, narrator got the meaning of change from Ranga. Okay, we'll carry on the chapter on... Okay, it's okay.